Yeah, I know what you're thinking. You can get a job in the Middle East simply by trying or by magic through others or by a fluke. Remember that competition is everywhere. Some here, some there, but bam, Loy Macedo is the best.
Now next one, the third point. Now the third point is 4 days a week. Okay, now here people have asked me, Loy, okay, COVID has disrupted the economy, disrupted our lifestyle. We are doing things we never thought we'd do before. Before Michael Jackson used to put a mask. If you don't know who Michael Jackson is, Google search. He was one of these creative, eccentric artists. But he used to wear a mask. And people say, what? What an abnormal guy. And today everyone does the same. So what a funny thing. Okay, so now, is 4 days a week going to be a reality? Now why 4 days a week? People are more productive, less exposure to, what do you call that, the virus, less exposure to other people. Fine. Okay, I thought I'll give my opinion about this. By the way, check that snake. This was lying on the road. I had to throw it here because I didn't want it to get squished. Funny, no? Snake, you want to see? See again. Snake. You see? Dead snake. I don't know what brand is it. Not brand. What kind of snake this is. Scary. Okay. So what does it say? Okay, 4 days a week. Now, listen. This is my thinking. You know this 4 days a week and 5 days a week. This concept, na, only comes from the West. You'll never hear it from the East. People in the East are always hardworking. They believe if you work, you get food to eat. They believe the government is not out there to take care of you. You are not self-entitled. You have to work in the farm and you have to reap the rewards. People in the East believe in hard work. They believe in sweat. They believe in their blood. They believe in effort. Okay. People in the West, no? Oh, this chair is paining me. Oh, I need a comfortable chair. So it's ergonomic. Oh, my feet have to be elevated to a position. So blood circulation. Oh, when I type, keep the keyboard this much. Keep a palm rest. Oh, there should be a rest for my neck. Oh, the beverage should be kept at an arm distance. Oh, can we have a dispensing machine where I have water, Coca-Cola, sandwiches, everything come close by. Oh, the AC is too cold. Can we have a temperature that's pleasing? Can we have some uplifting music? Oh, the way you talk to me is so harsh. It's hurting my feelings. I got a trauma. Oh, it has affected me psychologically because you didn't use positive reinforcement. You know, all this bullshit, no? It's only the West. Oh, I'm sick. Oh, the government has to take care of me. Oh, COVID, please. I need a stimulus package every month. Please send me, my wife, my children. You have to take care of us. Why? We are paying taxes. Oh, I can't. Try telling the same to people in India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, China. They'll say, are you fucking crazy? See, the sense of self-entitlement, this new generation that has come with all this bullshit, woke, sensitive, oh, I'm fragile, oh, all this is a Western concept. It's not Eastern. We, people from the East, no? We have grit. We have, we want to work hard. I'm not saying all the Westerners are bums. The people who work on the farms, tell them, ask them, those who are working on the farms, hey, what do you think of 4 days a week? They'll be like, what? Ask someone who works every day, has to open a shop and sell. Just imagine, just think, what if supermarkets were open 4 days a week? What if hospitals were open 4 days a week? What if engineering companies, everyone laid back 3 days, just switch off? No. What do people want to do during the 3 days off? Spend time with the family? Okay, then take unpaid leave, no? Spend time with the family. You want to get paid for taking rest? Then I'll tell you, company is also smart. They're not stupid. What they'll say is, oh yes, you're very fragile. Yes, yes. 4 days a week. Yes, yes. You're right. So we'll pay you per hour. Take how many ever days off you want. Take 2 days a week. 2 days you come to work. Take 1 day a week. Forget that. Take no day a week. Just sit home with your family. Relax. Enjoy. When you start paying them per hour, then, oh fuck, how will I pay electricity? How will I pay for food? And then they'll want to work hard. Can you imagine Steve Jobs or Bill Gates or any of the legends like Jeff Bezos, Elon Musk, having 4 days a week? I'll rest, take it easy. I'll play with my video game. I'll spend time with my family, go to the garden, the beach, suntan, suntan. Wow, this is life. Why people are not doing that? Tell me. Why athletes, people who train for greatness, you know, this mentality that is there, no? This is only for bums. This is only for lazy people. These are only for the waste of society. You know, these useless individuals. If you are someone who wants a good life, who believes that his values, his ethics, his morals, I need to work with the sweat on my brow, with the blood, you know, just thrown to the ground, and I'll feed my family. That kind of character will forever succeed. Employers are looking for such individuals, not a 4 day a week bum. If I was running a business, let's say in Denmark or somewhere, and I get this employee who comes and says, sir, even though it's four day a week, I'll work every day. I want to work. Give me work. I want to make money. If you're a businessman and you have this employee who comes to you and says, sir, this is how I want to work, what will you tell him? Wouldn't you like him? I'll give one final example. When I was in Dublin, Ireland, true story, huh? Me. When I was in Dublin, Ireland, my first wife had gone there in Glendalkin. There was a shopping mall which had a theater. Theater, you know, where they show cinema, movies. I remember that time Hulk, the first Hulk, Ang Lee, just was about to release after a few months. So I went there for a job. The only job they could give me is domestic engineer, it's called. Means you have to clean the toilets. Thankfully, the toilets are all clean, perfect clean, and people are not. Very few people used to come there. And the cinema halls were little dirt, popcorn here and there, juice. Okay. So we were domestic engineers. Now, for me, I was ambitious. I didn't want to work as, you know, a cleaner for the rest of my life. And what I noticed was most of the people who are working there, you know, for example, you clean the toilet, you have to sign what time you clean. So I was noticing they would clean once in 3 hours, once in 2 hours, even though they were supposed to clean once every hour. Some of them would just come lazily, write something and go back. And rest of the time they were sitting down and chit-chatting. I didn't want to chit-chat with them because they're not my friends. So what I started to do is, because I knew the management would see the papers, I would clean it. Even if there was nothing, I would ensure every 15 minutes, my signature would be there. Every 15 minutes. I would go check the toilets. I'd go check the cinema halls. And when all that work is over, I actually used to take a mop and used to sweep inside office and all that. And then when all that work was over, I literally used to go to the GM. The GM was a young guy. And tell him, excuse me, sir. He's saying, just call me with my name. I don't remember his name. But still, I'd call him sir out of respect. I'd tell him, sir, I finished the work. Can you give me some more work? I don't want to sit and waste my time. And he was like, huh? What? You would find it very surprising. You can just sit, relax, and there's no work. No, sir, I want to do some work. Please. He was like, you want to work? We'll be paying you anyhow. I said, no, I want to work. He was so impressed. He was like, okay, you would give me work. Clean this, clean that, clean this, clean that. And I'd never stop. In fact, even the break, there were two breaks. One was 15 minutes, one was 45 minutes, total 1 hour. So out of the 8 hours you work, 7 hours is work, 1 hour mandatory, you have to take an off. That's a rule. And they are steadfast. I would take my 15 minute break, but the second break, which was 45 minutes, I would take it like 5 minutes, 10 minutes, go back to work. Now, you might think, oh wow, Roy, this is impressive. You know, this was not impressive. You know what was impressive? After I finished my 8 hours of work, I was paid for 7 hours. They pay you for 8 hours. I would work another 8 hours for free. Seriously, not joking. I did this month after month after month. I'd work another 8 hours for free without pay. The management was so confused. The GM one day came, called me to the office. Why are you working? They're not paying you for this. I want to give you a warning. You cannot sue us and this and that. And even made me sign a disclaimer because he was worried I would sue him, sue the company or whatever. I gladly signed. I said, no, I'm doing for learning. I said, I want to learn. Can you put me in accounts? Can you put me in the call center? Can you put me in the ticketing? Can you put me in the serving the counter? Can you put me for somewhere? He was so impressed with me. And guess what? I got three times I got a level increase. I was the only guy. Within a period of 3 months, I got a bonus, I got extra, I got, you know, an added responsibility. Then they were going to give me the position. Anyway, many things happened after that, so I had to leave. Now, why am I sharing this with you? If you want to achieve greatness, if you want to make more money, if you want to fulfill your dreams, you need to work hard. Check any immigrant who goes abroad. They will work one job as maybe, I even met in Dublin, I met one guy who was a telecommunication engineer, Muslim guy from India. I think he was from Ahmedabad. It was very rare to meet an Indian. How did I meet him? I met him near a petrol station. I was helping with the petrol. And that also I met him in a night shift. So I could make out he was Indian and I asked him, hey man, where are you from? He told me India and I told, oh, that time I didn't have tattoos. This is at the age of 21. He said, oh, I'm from India and all that. So he said, you work as a gas attendant or petrol attendant? He said, no. I work in this gas station. Morning I work as an engineer and evening I work for this. So I asked him, why do you work two jobs? He said, I even work on my holidays. He's saying, I have a wife and baby. And then I said, is it because the pay is less? He said, no. He said, I'm taking the house on loan. I've taken a house and I want to make sure that the loan is cleared as quickly as possible so my family can have a good life. See, he's working hard to save money for him, his family, to buy a house. This is what hard-working people do. I'm very sure there are many Westerners who are like this. I'm very sure. I'm very sure there are many people who find this 4-hour work ridiculous. I can only sum up and tell you this much. This is just a lazy man's way of working less. And the newspapers talk about it, or the media, just for clicks, just to create hype, like this transgender movement, Black Lives Matter, change this street name, it's from a slave owner, remove that statue, remove this tree, change this painting, it's hurting my feelings. It's all bullshit. The real world doesn't work like this. This is what I'm telling you from a guy who today lives remote, but he works his ass off. Because for me, I don't know when it'll be my last day, when I might fall sick, when I'll lose this opportunity to make money. I don't know the future. I have to earn for my family. So this was the second question about 4-day a week.